Hello everyone, welcome again in our online session of Hello Alkanes and Hello Arenes part 10. In this session we are going to study some of the important reactions of haloarenes, that is aromatic haloarenes, aryl halides, some of the important reactions like nucleophilic substitution reaction of haloarenes, electrophilic substitution, as well as reaction of haloarenes with metals, right, that we are going to study in this online session. So we'll study some of the important chemical reactions of haloarenes, that is aromatic aryl halides. Mainly there are three type of reactions. First is nucleophilic substitution, second is electrophilic substitution reaction, and third is reaction with metal, right? This is nucleophilic, second electrophilic, and third, that is reaction with metals. So first we'll see nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloarenes, right? We'll see that. So as we know that most of the aromatic aryl halides are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. Means, as we have seen that alkyl halides previously in SN1 and SN2 reaction, alkyl halides can react with nucleophiles. They easily undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. But these aryl halides are extremely less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction, means SN1, SN2 reactions are very much rarely occurring in this aromatic, like chlorobenzene, bromobenzene or iodobenzene. So what are the important reasons why they do not undergo this nucleophilic substitution reaction? We'll discuss that. The first reason is resonance effect, or you can say mesomeric effect. Positive resonance effect as well as negative resonance effect, we know that. So here what is happening, there is a resonance effect occurred in presence of this chlorine atom, that is halogen atom, which is having lone pair of electrons. You can see the chlorine, total there are 6 electrons or 3 lone pairs are present. Will now one of the lone pair is taking part in resonance. You can see this lone pair is producing pi bond over here, right? And now it is rotating this, shifting this pi bond of aromatic on this carbon, so there is negative charge, and so on. Again, this bond will be shifted here. You can see it here, there is now pi bond. This electrons are shifting on the carbon atom, right? And again, what will happen? This electrons will produce pi bond over here, right? And this will produce negative charge on this carbon atom. So this effect will be continuously present in between these aromatic structures of chlorobenzene, right? So these resonating structures are continuously present, and in this there is a strong conjugation of pi electrons of this benzene ring. So due to this reason, the nucleophiles cannot easily remove this chlorine, right? This chlorine cannot be released easily. You cannot substitute chlorine with nucleophile easily due to this resonating structure, right? So first reason is resonance effect. Here it is mentioned that in haloarenes, the electron pairs of halogen atom, means the lone pair of halogen, are in conjugation with pi electrons of benzene ring, and due to that there are following resonating structures are possible. So in chlorobenzene or bromobenzene, even in iodobenzene, such type of resonating structures are present. And even you can see here, there is double bonds, partial double bond present between this carbon and halogen, that is chlorine. So even this chlorine is difficult to remove from this aromatic ring. Here the same thing is mentioned, that the carbon chlorine bond acquires partial double bond character, right? And this is due to resonance effect which is generated. So as a result, it is difficult to break this carbon and chlorine bond, right? Then as compared to haloalkane, means in aliphatic you can easily break the carbon and halogen bond, while in aromatic it is difficult to break the carbon and halogen bond. So as a result, they are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction, right? So they will leastly undergo SN1 or SN2 reactions. Second reason is the hybridization of carbon atom. You can see in aliphatic the carbon is sp3 hybrid carbon, while in aromatic this all carbons of benzene ring, they are sp2 hybrid, and the halogen is bonded to sp2 hybrid carbon, while in aliphatic it is bonded to sp3 hybrid. So this halogen of sp3 can be easily removed, right? While here it is difficult to remove this halogen present on sp2 hybrid carbon, right? So there is a difference in hybridization of bonded carbon atoms. So as we know that, as there is a difference between the hybridization sp2 and sp3, sp2 in aromatic, sp3 in aliphatic, so there is a difference in s character. At percentage, s orbital is more in sp2 hybrid, it is 33.33% s character in sp2 hybrid, while it is only 25% s character in sp3 hybrid. So as a result, the s character is more negative, greater in sp2 carbon, right, and can hold this bond more tightly, more strongly than sp3, right? Because in sp3 the s character is only 25%, while here it is 33.33% in sp2 hybrid. So in short, this bond is more stronger, right, as compared to this carbon and halogen in aliphatic. So you can easily break this bond, you can react with nucleophile, it can undergo nucleophilic reaction, while this bond is stronger, so it do not break easily and do not undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction, right? And even you can see the bond length is also different. Here the bond length is 177, over here this carbon halogen distance is 177 picometers, while here the distance is 169 picometers. So you can see this bond is shorter, 169, here it is 177, larger and shorter. So it is difficult to break the shorter bond. They are more closely attracted with each other as the bond length is shorter, while here it is longer, right? So it is difficult to break in this sp2, and it is easier to break in this sp3 carbon. It is mentioned here, since difficult to break the shorter bond, which is 169 present in haloarine in aromatic ring, right, and then the longer bond in haloalkane, you can easily break this bond. So as a result, their haloarenes are less reactive than haloalkane towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is one of the second important reason. The third reason is instability of phenyl cation, means when you are removing the halogen atom, suppose for example, if you are taking out this halogen, right, you are removing this halogen, so now this carbon of the benzene ring will produce cation, right? Same way, when you are removing the halogen from this carbon, right, the X would be removed as X minus, negatively charged, while this carbon will gain positive charge, while carbocation will be generated. So here they are saying that if cation is produced on this aromatic ring, this would be less stable, while this cation on aliphatic carbon chain would be more stable, right? So as a result, the aromatics will less undergo this SN1 reaction due to instability of phenyl cation. It is mentioned here that haloarenes, the phenyl cation formed as a result of self-ionization, will not be stabilized by resonance, means positively charged carbon on benzene ring is not stabilized by resonance. So therefore SN1 mechanism is ruled out. It do not undergo this SN1 reaction, right? That is third important reason. Fourth is because of the possible repulsion. Now why repulsion? Here it is indicated because you can see the benzene ring is aromatic, right? And there is, you can see here the electrons are revolving, right, around the carbon atom, and there is negative charge on this benzene ring. And when you are trying to add nucleophile on this benzene ring, again nucleophile is negatively charged, or either it is having lone pair. Same way this benzene is having negative charge due to resonance. So due to negative charges, there is repulsion between nucleophile and this benzene ring. So here it is discussing that because of possible repulsion, it is likely for electron rich nucleophile will approach the electron rich haloarenes. So due to electron rich nucleophiles and haloarenes, there is repulsion between them, and so the reaction rate is less with nucleophiles, right? That is one of the fourth reason. So all the reasons are summarized over here, why these aryl halides are extremely less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. First is due to resonance effect. Second is due to difference in hybridization of carbon atom, that is sp2 in aromatic and sp3 in aliphatic. Third is instability of phenyl cation. Just now we have seen this cation on aromatic ring is less stable, and because of repulsion between aromatic ring and nucleophile, it do not easily undergo this nucleophilic reaction, right? So these are reasons summarized over here. So even if we are trying to do this nucleophilic reaction on haloarene, then we require more vigorous condition if we want to do this nucleophilic substitution reaction, that is SN1 or SN2 on this haloarene, right? Then we have to apply high temperature, high pressure, in presence of some catalyst, some reagents are required, means some of the vigorous experimental conditions are required, then and only then these haloarenes will undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. So some of the reactions are also mentioned here, that if we want to remove this chlorine and we want to introduce this OH minus, that is hydroxyl group. So here this OH minus will work like nucleophile and it is trying to displace this chlorine. So here we have taken sodium hydroxide NaOH. This NaOH will release OH minus. This OH minus of NaOH works like nucleophile and will displace this chlorine, right, and produces the compound is phenol, right? And this process is known as Dow's process, one of the important industrial method of preparation of phenol, right? So here you can see it is mentioned at 623 Kelvin and 300 atmospheric pressure in presence of acidic medium, right, or either simply water can be used in this reaction or acidic medium. So in this case the nucleophile would be OH minus and it is displacing this chlorine, but the condition is we require high temperature and high pressure, 300 bar, much high pressure and higher temperature are required, then only this nucleophilic substitution reaction can be carried out, right? Here it is shown some comparison. Now here in chlorobenzene there is nitro group on para position, so it requires again same reagent NaOH, but you can see the temperature is less. Previously we have seen that the temperature is 623 Kelvin, the pressure is very much high, 300 bar pressure, 300 atmospheric pressure, and simply this chlorobenzene, right? And there is no functional group present here. The temperature is 623 Kelvin, right? But now here you can see that the temperature here it is taken is 443, right? In presence of this nitro group, and it is displacing this chlorine by this OH group. Same way you can see in second reaction also, this chlorobenzene with two nitro groups, right? 2,4-dinitrochlorobenzene requires again very much low temperature, 368. You can see the difference, and it produces phenol. So why this low temperatures are required, or you can say why the reaction is more easier in presence of this nitro groups? Because see, the nitro is electron withdrawing group, right? Or you can say EWG group or G group. This nitro group will try to withdraw the electrons from this benzene ring, right? And it will try to release this chlorine more faster, and the OH minus that is produced from NaOH will easily bind on this carbon atom, right? So the temperature is lower, rather than previously we have seen it is 623 Kelvin, but here the temperature taken is 443 Kelvin, right? In presence of this nitro group, right? So shown here it is that presence of electron withdrawing group like nitro at ortho and para position increases the reactivity of haloarenes towards this nucleophilic substitution reaction, right? So this NaOH will more faster displace this chlorine in presence of nitro, and even there are two nitro groups, then the reaction is more easier at 368 Kelvin and will produce 2,4-dinitrophenol, right? Same way in third one you can see there are now three nitro groups, 2,4,6-trinitrochlorobenzene, right? 2,4,6-trinitrochlorobenzene, and here simply you have to just warm the solution, no temperature is required. Even the NaOH is not used, even you can use simply water. The OH minus of water can also displace this chlorine, and it will bind over here the hydroxyl group. The compound is 2,4,6,2,4,6-trinitrophenol. Commonly it is also known as picric acid. It is in common name, right? So you can see here it is mentioned that the pronounced effect of nitro group at ortho and para position can be seen, but however there is no effect of reactivity of haloarenes observed by electron withdrawing at meta position. So this is only related to ortho and para position, as we have seen that the temperature is decreasing. Previously it was 623 Kelvin. Previously in Dow's process we have seen that here it is 623 Kelvin. In presence of one nitro group it is 443 Kelvin. So as we are adding more and more nitro groups, the temperature is going on decreasing, means the reaction is more easier. And at last we have seen that if there are three nitro groups, you have to just warm the solution with water and easily produces the compound is picric acid, which is shown here. It is crystalline form, crystals, needle shaped crystals of picric acid. Here it is in solution form in water. It is powdered picric acid. It is yellow colored compound, right, which is produced here. Next reaction is electrophilic substitution reaction in haloarenes, that is ESR reaction. Electrophilic substitution, we have studied previously about nitration, halogenation, chlorination, bromination, sulfonation, right? Friedel-Crafts, alkylation, acylation, all these reactions, they belong to electrophilic substitution reaction. that we'll see in haloarenes, right? So mostly these haloarenes, they easily undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. See, there is a difference. Haloarenes do not undergo nucleophilic substitution, and even we have seen the reasons why they do not undergo this nucleophilic, but haloarenes usually easily undergo electrophilic substitution reaction, just like benzene ring, that's like halogenation reaction, nitration, sulfonation, and Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So all this halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation and acylation, all these are type of electrophilic reaction. They are easily occurring because we know that the halogen atom donates its electrons and it involves in conjugation with benzene ring. You can see here, previously we have seen this, that halogen will try to donate its electrons in conjugation with benzene ring, and there is cyclic resonance, right? You can see here, and there is partial pi bond character present between carbon and halogen, right? And due to this reason, there is negative charge. You can see here, negative on para position, ortho position, right? Again, this ortho position. So on ortho and para, there is negative charge. So any electrophile or any positively charged ion can easily bind on this negatively charged carbon. Means electrophiles can easily react with benzene ring due to negative charge on this benzene ring, right? So as a result, you can say that haloarenes easily undergo electrophilic reaction because there is negative charge on this benzene ring during this resonance effect, right? Here it is shown that due to resonance effect, the electron density increases more and more at ortho and para positions rather than in meta position. You can see here in ortho and para position, this is ortho, right? 1, 2 is ortho, 1, 4 is para, and again 1, 2 is ortho. So here on ortho and para position, there is more electron density. Electrons are more in this position, right? So what here it is saying, that due to this higher electron density at ortho and para positions rather than meta, further halogen causes minus I effect, has some tendency to withdraw electrons from benzene ring, right? Negative inductive of benzene ring, and as a result, the ring gets somewhat deactivated as compared to benzene. Hence, electrophilic substitution reaction in haloarenes occurs slowly and requires more drastic conditions as compared to normal benzene. Means here it is saying that pure benzene easily or rapidly undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction, while here due to presence of halogen in haloarenes or halobenzene, the halogen induces minus I effect, right? It acts as electron withdrawing group. So here the ring slightly gets deactivated. And electrons can be slightly attracted towards halogen atoms, so the rate of reaction would be slightly slower as compared to pure benzene, what it is explained over here, right? Some of the electrophilic substitution reactions are mentioned here. First is halogenation, that is chlorination. Chlorobenzene reacted with chlorine in presence of anhydrous FeCl3 as a catalyst, and as we know that there is more density on ortho and para position, negative charge, so this chlorine electrophile produced will bind on this para position and ortho position. Here para would be a major product, right? And this ortho would be minor product. So here we are getting mixture of two isomers. Here it is 1,4 dichlorobenzene, and here it is 1,2 dichlorobenzene. Mixture of both isomers together. Same way, second is nitration reaction, and we know the nitrating mixture is concentrated HNO3 plus concentrated H2SO4, that is nitric acid mixed with sulfuric acid, that is very good nitrating mixture, will produce ortho nitro and para nitro derivative, or you can say 1 chloro 2 nitro benzene and 1 chloro 4 nitro benzene. This para would be major product. Para isomer, we have seen that para is major here also, and ortho would be minor product, right? Here it is shown yellow colored crystalline compounds, it is chloro nitro benzene, ortho chloro and para chloro nitro benzene. They are yellow crystalline compounds. Similarly, another is sulfonation reaction. In this, we are using sulfonating reagent, that is concentrated H2SO4, or you can take fuming sulfuric acid, that is also known as oleum, right? H2S2O7, that oleum at high temperature or fuming sulfuric acid will create SO3 radicals, right? And they will bind on this ortho and para position, will produce sulfonic acid, right? SO3H is sulfonic acid group. So it is 2 chloro, first will be this carbon, second would be chlorine. So on second there is chlorine atom, and one there is sulfonic group. So it is mentioned 2 chloro benzene sulfonic acid, right? And here it is on fourth position, first is SO3H and fourth is chlorine. So 4 chloro benzene sulfonic acid. And as we know that para would be, again it is symmetrical, so para would be major product and ortho would be minor product. Here it is shown white colored crystalline compound, chlorobenzene sulfonic acid. Next is one of the important reaction, that is Friedel-Crafts reaction. One is alkylation and another is acylation. Acylation is also named as acetylation, that we already studied in previous classes. Right, Friedel-Crafts reagent, that is anhydrous, AlCl3 is common in both alkylation as well as acylation. So here this CH3Cl or alkyl halide is reagent, will bind on this ortho and para position. So methyl group gets bonded on ortho and para position, right? Here it is 2 methyl 1 chloro 2 methyl benzene, here it is 1 chloro 4 methyl benzene, and as para is major product and the ortho would be minor product, right? Same way, second is acetylation or acylation. Here it is ethanoyl chloride, you can see first carbon, second carbon, ethanoyl chloride or acetyl chloride. This total acetyl group, COCH3 group, will get bonded on this ortho and para position. You can see here COCH3, this total group, as well as COCH3. The acetyl group gets bonded on ortho and para position. So this is 2 chloroacetophenone, right? Or orthochloroacetophenone, and this is parachloroacetophenone, right? We know that COCH3 on benzene is known as acetophenone, right? Benzene and COCH3 is acetophenone. This total compound is acetophenone. And here this is first carbon and this is second carbon. So second there is chlorine. So 2 chloroacetophenone, right? Same way, this total compound, again it is acetophenone. This is first carbon, this is second, this is third and fourth. So on fourth there is chlorine, right? So 4 chloro acetophenone, and we know again para is major product and ortho would be minor product, right? So this is acetylation, or you can say Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, and here it is Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, right? Both belongs to electrophilic substitution reaction. Next is reactions with metals of haloarenes. Again, this we have seen in the previous session, that Wood's reaction and Wood's fatigue as well as fatigue, these are two important reactions of haloarenes with metals. One is Wood's fatigue and second is fatigue reaction. We know that in Wood's fatigue, what is happening? One is aliphatic alkyl halide and second is aromatic aryl halide, right? And reagent is sodium in dry ether, right? Dry ether is the solvent. So the sodium binds with halogen, as well as sodium will bind with halogen of this RX. You can see this R group is bonded on this benzene ring, right? So it produces alkyl benzene, means R displaces this halogen, right? And this sodium will bind with both the halogens, produces sodium halide, and production is, or main production is alkyl halide, right? Aryl halide is our major product, which is produced over here, right? It is known as Wood's fatigue reaction. Again, the reagent is same, dry ether is solvent, and sodium in dry ether. And similar is Wittig's reaction, and in this also you can see here the two moles of this haloarene is taken with two sodium in dry ether, and again this sodium will bind with halogen to give sodium halide NaX, and two moles of this benzene ring, both benzene will bind together, and the product is biphenyl, which is shown here, white crystalline compound. Biphenyl, or you can say diphenyl, both are joined together, and this is known as Wittig's reaction, right? So Wittig is only for both aromatic rings when they are joined together, while you can see Wood's Wittig, one is aliphatic, right? Another is aromatic. Both are taken together is known as Wood's Wittig. But when only there are both aromatic compounds, two moles of aromatic, it is known as Wittig's reaction, right? So these are some of the important reactions of haloarenes, right? We'll study some more reactions also in our next session, right? So thank you all of you for joining this online session, right? Thank you. Have a nice day.